Oh, Jesus. Just to see you lift up your hand, bless the name of the Lord. Bless Him for this evening, for the gift of your life, for the wonders of this week He has done in our different lives, successes, progress, healing, protection, guidance, going out and coming back, challenges, fights from different fields, but he has brought you to safety. Abba, Father, we thank you. We glorify you. He who fights our battle, he who defends us, the unchangeable changer, the unshakable shaker, the unmoved mover, the summum bonum. We bless you. We glorify you. You that changes the course of events in our favor. We pray that any events programmed that is not in our favor, that it be changed by you tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Demonic influences and projections, may they be expelled and disgraced in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any territory handed over to the devil, we reclaim it this night in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we sensitize this environment with the power in the blood of Jesus. We sensitize it with the power in the blood of Jesus. Every kingdom, every stronghold that has been possessed, may that kingdom, may that stronghold be released in the name of Jesus. And may heaven honor his name tonight in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, the Lord is with you. Tell it to someone, the Lord is with you. And the Lord will bless you. Amen. Let us sit. Amen. I'd like us to look at Luke's Gospel, chapter 11, verse 24. Please, can you change the Gospel? Okay. Sorry, can I see the other microphone this way, please?
Amen. Gospel of Luke, chapter 11, verse 24. When an evil spirit comes out of a man, he goes through arid places seeking rest and does not find it. Then it says, I will return to the house I left. Verse 25. When it arrives, it finds the house swept clean and put in order. Then it goes and takes seven other spirits more wicked than itself, and then go in and live there. And the final condition of that man is worse than the first. As Jesus was saying this thing, a woman in the crowd called out.
Stop. It's okay. That's 24 to 26.
Okay.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I just want to talk about be what? Alert. Or be on the alert. Amen. Be what?
Alert.
Ask your neighbor, are you alert? What did the person say? Are you sure you're alert? Ask the person again, why should you be on alert? What did he say? You're laughing. I'm serious. Ask the person, why should you be on the alert? And what did he answer? Eh? There is danger. There is danger. That you go to church is not enough. If you go to church and you are not alert, you'll be attacked. And when the attack comes, he says the first condition will be worse than the what? The second one. That's what the text of scripture says this evening. Praise the Lord. So you must know the mind of God in order to be victorious. Amen. The media, please help us with Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6. Chapter 12, sorry, verse 12. It says, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly world, realms. Don't worry, we'll come back to those other parts. But that is what I want us, that is why we are in a battle. Against what? Not against physical authority. Sorry, is there anybody in this church called Peter Eze? Anybody in this church like that? Anybody here called Peter Eze? Or anybody here who knows Peter Eze? You know the person? Is he in church? Huh? Amen. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we are in a battle with a force that is not physical. And the only way you can confront this force is also what? Spiritual. Now, Jesus gave that message in Luke's gospel to tell us the severity of what we need to do and why we must take him seriously. Otherwise, we'll be consumed. Some of us Christians, we dangle. One leg here, one leg what? There. Even right now, some of us in this church, one leg is inside, one leg is what? Outside. And when it is that way, from the text of scripture, the Lord points out something to us. And that fact is about cleansing the temple that is of God, which is our body. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. It says, do you not know, from verse 16, do you not know that your body is the temple of what? Can I hear you? Your body is the temple of what? The Holy Spirit. Do you not know that he who unites himself with a prostitute is one with her in body? For it is said, the two will become one flesh. Go up to verse. But whoever is united with the Lord is one with him in spirit. Flee from sexual immorality. Just move down to get back to all that. Get verse 18. Verse 19, please. Do you not know that your bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. And so you cannot do it anyhow. You were bought with a price. Therefore, honor God with your what? Bodies. Praise the Lord. Now, it is this body that Jesus speaks about that the devil has been given an opportunity to possess. And when he has possessed it, there is only one person who will bring about your deliverance. And that person, I want you to shout the name, is who?
Jesus.
That is not loud enough. Is who?
Jesus.
Is who?
Jesus.
Yes. And that is the external cleansing. External cleansing comes from Jesus. But when you cleanse yourself by yourself, it becomes ineffective. That's why sometimes some of us, we think that our salvation and our righteousness will carry us over. It cannot carry you anywhere. Now, Jesus' statement in that text of scripture tells us and forewarns us. When you say, self-righteousness, I do works of charity, I do that, without Jesus, is what? Babash. He says the devil will come back, and when he comes back, he will be fiercer than before. Now, dear friends, I want us to look at the ranks and file of the satanic kingdom. The ranks and file of the satanic kingdom that we need to be weary about. And that is what Paul draws our attention to in Ephesians chapter 6, when he mentioned principalities and powers. Now, in the rank and file, the ranks and file of the satanic kingdom, you have Lucifer. And the product that Lucifer sells out to us is pride. Praise the Lord. Is what? Ask your neighbor, are you proud? Are you arrogant? How do you carry yourself around? If you are always like this, who is like me? You are being influenced by that rank of what? Lucifer is a rank. Pompous. And it's a window of return. Because it says seven. We're going to look at the seven demons or spirits that will come back with the one that was chased out. And then it says the next one is Beelzebub. That's the gospel reading of today. When they accused Jesus and said, he cast out devils through the prince of what? Beelzebub. Praise the Lord. So the second, and what does it sell to you? What does it carry around? What does Beelzebub carry? Envy and jealousy. Ask your neighbor, are you envious of people? Are you jealous? What did he say? Ask yourself, am I envious or jealous? Are you sure you are not? You know they jealous my shoe. You know they jealous my car. jealous? Is he the only person? Is she the only person? Why must he be him every time? Him, him. Or why must he be her, her, her? Is he the only person in this church? Is she the only person in this church? Jealousy and what? Envy. We do not appreciate the gift of people. And so it's a window you open for the devil to come. That is why many of us will go to church and nothing is happening in our lives and around us. Because we wear jealousy and envy as what? Clothes. It's a rank and an order of the satanic kingdom to be envious and jealous. The other one is Satanas, or Satan itself, and that is what? Rots. Rots. And then the other one is Abaddon, or Abaddon, which has to do with sloths, being slothful. And then the other one is Mammon, greed. You want to get everything, everything. You grab this one, you grab that one, you grab this position. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. In one parish, as they did this election for different offices, a particular person was appointed by the priest, but the priest later discovered that he made a mistake and went to do election. The woman, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Before you knew it, they wrote petition to bishop about the parish priests. Bishop gave order and sent me and some person there to go and reconduct the election. First of all, they had written petition because they did not succeed in the CWO. So this CWO was dissolved and they did another election. And then we came to laity, the same thing. Bishop had to send me with some other person who went and conducted the election. And then other problems. Now, the woman, in fact, wrote another petition, came reporting the priest to me as the dean, and I spoke to her with her group and all that. And the problem is increasing. I spoke to her and said, leave this thing just because of a position. Because of a position, and is not satisfied. Even after I've spoken to her as the dean of the deanery, went and reported the priest to another priest. And then that priest said, okay, don't worry, I will take the matter to the bishop. So she still wants to go back to the bishop to report the priest because of a position of 4 years. Greed. She wants to be in the what? Position. Greed. You do business with people, you cheat them. That is a part of the devil that is operational in you. It's a rank of the devil. You might be going to church. There are some people in this church. They are so greedy. Anything you do that they are not involved, they are angry. Father Ben is a very wicked man. He's walking alone. Can somebody walk alone? In a church like this, you cannot walk alone. As we celebrated the Mass, Father Francis celebrated Mass. No be so. Now me they talk now, Abby. Now me sing. Now me play organ. Arrow. Let God deliver us. In the name of Jesus. Greed is an order of the satanic kingdom. And then the order that is called Belphegor. Gluttony. Angroma. If you don't drink, you go die. May God deliver you. Every kind of drink, every time, drink, 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 drink. You go drink, 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 drink. They come back house. You go miss road to your house. You go your neighbor house, go knock. Pop, 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 pop. Then they go carry you from your neighbor house. Come, madam, see your husband do. Gluttony. Everything you see, you do what? Chop. You chop meat, you chop fish, you chop anything that into the mouth, do what? When you finish eating, you now sleep. You become useless. You eat yourself to stupidity.
glutton, to be a glutton. Any kind of, well, once it has to do with eat. You eat, and eat poison. And then eventually the person does what? Dies. Or they give you the kind of poison that odendo, onye nwana mwumeregini, kama. Because it's a rank of the, what does this scripture say? It says that the second condition will be worse than the word first. You are diabetic. They tell you, don't drink this, don't eat this. Ah, something must kill a man. Okay, book one, okay. Praise the Lord. Amen. That is the sixth rank of the devil. And then the other rank is Asmodeus. That is the spirit that ignites the appetite for lusts. Lustful kind of life that St. Paul talks about. That eventually makes you not to realize that your body is the temple of the world, Holy Spirit. Some people lust for everything. They lust for women. They lust for money. They lust for car. They lust for land. They lust for anything that is to be possessed. They are lustful about it. No self-control. No discipline. Praise the Lord. So that is the rank. So that you be aware. And some persons, all these live in them. I don't know. Is it true? Eh? Have you ever seen somebody that all these kind of characters lives in the person? Yes. There are people like that. They go to church, but everything about that. So you can imagine where this grace of demonic powers dwell in the person. There are some people in the church, in the society, in the club where they belong to, when once they come for meeting is ended that day. Praise the Lord. They are, what dwells in them is spirit of what? Confusion. Spirit of confusion. Amen. Now, in the description of St. Paul about this in Ephesians chapter 6, he started with the word principalities. And that word principalities comes from the Greek word archai, which means ancient times. Now, these are individual or spiritual beings that hold highest and lofty positions of honor, that control. These powers have been from the ancient time. And this has to do with Satan. From ancient time, he was given power and authority. Though he fell, but he still held onto that word, power. And so these are grades of spirits that are that level of oppression that eventually manipulate people. They manipulate human beings. They manipulate everything because it has been given for them, to them, from what? Ancient times. So we need to be weary about it. These are the grace of powers and forces that this spirit that was cast out of the body goes to invite. Because in that text it says it travels through waterless spirit. That's why sometimes when we pray for people who have been delivered, said we cast you out to the dry world, desert, to remain there and never to return until the resurrection morning. You change that spirit that it does not return to that body, especially when the doors are not opened again to that spirit. And so Paul uses that as a force. It's a power. They hold power, spiritual powers and strongholds. And then he also talks about power. Another grade of this spirit is power. And this power from the Greek word has to do with exousia. And exousia deals with delegated authority. They have been delegated authority. They are demon spirits that have been delegated authority or power to menace, to destroy, to mismanage and mangle your life and make you useless. That's why when they come and they habit in you, you are a finished man. And then the other one, it talks about rulers of darkness of this world. That word, rulers of darkness, has a compound Greek word known as cosmokrateros. Cosmokrateros. Divided into two, you have cosmos. And this cosmos of demons as powers, it has to do with order and arrangement. Order of demons and the way they are being arranged in order that they might attack. And then the other one, Kratos, that has to do with raw power. When power is raw one. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Bro. Raw acid. You dilute raw acid, Abby. If you don't dilute raw acid and pour it on something, what happens? It destroys it completely. So, this power has to do with raw. You see, the power is what? I want to hear you talk. The power is what? When they say you are too raw, that is something, is something you cannot. So that is now this grade of demonic powers or principalities. He said they have this word has to do with command, and the command is raw, very raw. So that wherever they are, this command has been harnessed and put into some kind of order. And it is uses the word military terms. Now, when the military advertises for people to join the military, a lot of young people do what? Report. They apply and they are taken. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Are you tired? Now, when they gather, when these young men and women come together, you see a lot of them, they have raw energy. They want to be in the military. They want to be soldiers. And they come. Their power and energy just scatter. So they now begin to drill them, train them. In the process of training, some people will die. They will throw away you and go and bury you. They won't even bring you back to your place. That's what happens when people go for army training. When they come back, you see some of them, their neck is icky. You think that they have been sick because of the rigorous training. And when they finish that training, they now organize that raw power they have into an ordered form, disciplined form. That's why you see soldiers, when they come, they move in regiments. And when they move in regiment and unleash their power, it is raw, but commanded power and authority. When the commander gives an order and they attack, what happens? They conquer. So this is the kind of way these spiritual powers are prepared and trained by the devil. So that when they are not given a command, they do what? They go. That's why the man who was cast out, the devil that was cast out in a man, Jesus asked, what is your name? He said, my name is what? I want to hear you. My name is what? Legion, meaning we are what? Many, but prepared with raw power, waiting for a command to strike. So that when we strike, nobody will be able to do what? Stand. Some of us are under such influence because we have opened the door. Amen. Amen. So, dear brothers and sisters, Satan's mission is to steal, kill, and do what? Destroy humanity. That's why he says he goes out when he has wandered around the place and does not find any. Then it invites, very emphatic, it invites other seven more wicked demons to return into the place that it has been cast out, so that it can now do what? Destroy and do wicked things. Then Paul identifies the one he calls spiritual wickedness in the high places. From the Greek root of that word, with spiritual wickedness, it talks about pornes, pornes, poorness or poorest has to do with something that is bad, vile, evil, malevolent force, vicious, and impious, malignant. They are so wicked, so wicked. When they are dealing with you, they don't look back. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Have you met such people before? There are some people, don't you ever have a case with them. If you have a case with them, they don't look what? Back. When they are dealing with you. In fact, it excites them to see you suffering. They see you in pain. They are happy. They will tell you, me and you in this Port Harcourt, by the time I finish dealing with you, when you hear my name or name of somebody like that, you will do what? You will run away. Those people they have that spirit, that spiritual authority that is operational in their life. They have been overtaken by this force. That is what he's warning us about today. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now the question is, how come they have this kind of influence over our lives? Because we go to church, but we don't know what we are what doing. Amen. We open the door to them, and so they take over. Remember, that man was delivered, and then the devil came back. When the devil and his agents are homeless, they don't operate from a vacuum, they operate from somewhere. And so we want to use a place as a base where they arise and go and come back, go and come back. That is why sometimes when some of you, prayer is said over you, you are delivered, at the end of the day, your condition, guess what? Worse, because you opened the door wide. Amen. Tell your neighbor, be weary. Tell him, be weary. Because the devil is prowling around like a roaring what? Looking for someone to do what? In Job chapter 1 and 2, the children of God gathered, and Satan did what? Came. And what was the question put to him? Where have you been? He said, I've been there all around the place, moving around from east to west, not to what? South, looking for somebody to do what? Destroy. And God said, did you see my servant Job? He said, yes. Is he? Job, because you have blessed him so much. Remove your hand and see. He will curse you. God said, you have my permission. And what did he do? He started destroying the man in order to make a mess of him. But God forbid, it will not be your portion. But my dear brothers and sisters, we don't open the door for the devil. We open the door with our attitudes. And the devil takes a few days in our lives. Media, please, can you help me with Proverbs chapter 6? Proverbs chapter 6 from verse 16. These are some of the things that we do that open us up, and the devil returns to deal with us and begins to wicked us in such a manner that it becomes difficult for us. Praise the Lord. Then the word of God says, there are six things the Lord hates, seven that are detestful to him. Six things, and then add to them seven, they are detestful to the Lord. He said, a haughty what? Eyes. A lying what? A lying what? Is your tongue a lying one? Ask yourself, is your tongue a lying one? Ask your neighbor, is your tongue a lying one? Praise the Lord. Some of us know truth in our mouth. Where did you go? I went to church, but they went to Rukboku. But they calculate when adoration will come back so that they will follow people and do what?
and go. Towards the end of the adoration, they will enter church. As people are leaving the church, they will do what? They will follow. When they reach us, their parents will ask. I say, I went to what? Church. Ezioku.
In the family, you never tell the truth. You lie to your parents. Some of us lie and lie and lie to ourselves, such that they no longer know themselves, because they cannot even speak truth to themselves. Lie.
Business people, they are uncountable.
Eh? Not just lying, they will swear in the name, brother, I think in the name of Christ, Jesus, eh? This thing, if not be the price, well, I buy them. In fact, yeah, they don't add extra on top. Lie, lie.
Say a lying word, tongue, the Lord does what? Detects.
Some of us in the office, some that lie with biro. We lie, 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 lie. We contaminate ourselves. That's why it says, beware of the tongue, because it destroys you or makes you.
Amen.
Lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood. Are you seeing the windows through which the devil comes back to you? Have you shed blood before? Worse, says innocent what? You give information to people about somebody and the person is destroyed. Character assassination. Or is it the number of abortions that we commit? We kill. A heart that devises wicked schemes. Many of us in different positions and in different places, we have devised a means that people will remain perpetually in poverty. Look at our political system in this country and elsewhere. The politicians, some of them have devised a political strategy that will keep people suffering and suffering and suffering and suffering, but they are swimming in what? In wealth. Praise the Lord. Amen. Feet that are quick to rush into evil. Okunagagini wam wam. Okunagagini wam wam. In our contemporary time, you talk about runs girls and runs men and runs boys. Yahoo boys. Devising means. Then a false witness who pours out lies and a person who stirs up conflict in the community. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Which group do you belong to? Which group do you belong to? Ask your neighbor, which group are you? Presido, former Presido, TWO. Eh? When Presido stands to talk, they go take for background, say, you know, go walk. There are men and women who progress is horrible in their ears and their sight. Agents of destruction, agents of destabilization, anything that they are not a part of, in fact, not even that they are part of, even if they are a part of it from the inside, they want to cause what? Confusion, so that the place will not grow. I want to make sure that this group scatters. Praise the Lord. Have you ever behaved like that? That kind of attitude is devilish. It's coming from a demonic controlled mind and heart. And he says, the Lord does what? Hates it. I pray, child of God, that your deliverance will come from Jesus. And so the question is, how do I guard the house? How do I guard my heart? Just like that song we sang in Anyinonara, we are in a battle with a kingdom that is strategized and disciplined. How do you overrun this kingdom and this organized army of the enemy? It is by what? They apply discipline. Remember, the principalities and powers and rulers of wickedness of this world, they apply what? Discipline. That's when they combine Kratos power and authority. They used it and organized themselves and they unleashed war. Child of God, we cannot continue to be indisciplined in our spiritual pursuits. In our journey, we have been redeemed by Jesus. That's why the word of God says, he who is in Christ Jesus is a new world creature. That house was being bombarded again by devilish powers and satanic powers because that house was not guarded by the power of God. Your repentance is not complete until when you confess Jesus as your personal Lord and what? Savior. When you confess Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, then you repent of a particular sin. That some of us have allowed particular sins to overtake us. They will wear those sins as cloth. Today, the Lord is calling us to repentance. Repent from your sin. Turn away from evil. Turn to Jesus. Turn to God. Accept the word of God. Begin to pray the word of God. Begin to obey the word of God. Begin to wear it as cloth. Then when you do that, the devil will not find an entrance. He will not find a window into your heart in order to manipulate and mangle you. And that's why many of us are going through what we are going through in life. Praise the Lord. Amen. So what are you proud of? What you should be proud of is Jesus. Can I hear everybody say that? We should be proud of what? Jesus. He is our Savior and He is our deliverer. And that is why Peter would then exhort us, stand up in faith. We must be firm in our faith conviction. Some of us are not firm. We dangle any small thing. Some of us are in the church. You come for adoration every day, but your leg is somewhere. Some of you, some of us in this church, we come to church, but we go elsewhere to make sacrifice. The Lord is saying today, repent. Especially the young men. The Lord is accusing a lot of young people, a lot of men. Double standard. You come to church, but your leg is still somewhere else. The Lord says, return from that place. Otherwise, something that is awaiting you will be disastrous. It is either you are for Jesus or you are not for Jesus. It is either you are for God or you are not for God. If you are for God, be for Him, whole and what? Entire. Abandon ways of wickedness. Return to Him. And then your blessings will be assured. Can I hear you say amen? Somebody would then ask me, Father, what do I need to do? How do I do it? We must put on the full armor of God. If you want salvation, if you want total deliverance, Ephesians chapter 6. Media, return to that text for me. Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 16 or from verse 18. We struggle not against flesh and blood, principalities and powers and evil. Move down, please. Then he says, and pray in the spirit on all occasions. Pray in the spirit with all kinds of prayer and requests. With this in mind, that's why again Jesus in teaching his disciples in Luke's gospel, chapter 11 from verse 1 to 4, 5, 6, we talk about, emphasize about prayer. And then he will say, pray always, pray in season and out of season. Prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I didn't hear you. I did not hear you. I did not hear you. I did not hear you. He said, be what? Alert. What did I say today? Be what? Alert. Be alert and always keep on praying for all the lost world people and for yourself. He says, keep on praying. Pray also for me that whenever I speak, words may be given to me so that I will fearlessly make known the mystery of the word of the gospel for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearlessly as I should. If you do not pray, you will not be able to withstand it. He says, put on the whole armor of God. We must put on the whole armor of God in order to be able to stand. And one of those, he said, the belt of righteousness, the belt of truth must be spoken with your tongue. You must always speak the truth, always. Amen. When you do that, when the devil returns, he will not find your place scattered, and he will flee from you. Can I hear somebody say amen? Amen. I said the devil will flee from you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You must confidently believe the word of God and act it out in order that you might be able to withstand the forces of the devil. Look at the great nation of demonic powers and operations. They come in subtle ways. Sometimes you might start up your life, you are proud, you think that it's normal. And somebody will call your attention. You say, no, I'm not proud now. Am I proud? Eh? Am I proud? Do I look proud? Do I behave proudly? That's what you'll be asking people. But you are exhibiting it without knowing. And gradually, it becomes a part of you. Lust. Some persons think that today being lustful is only when you are, when you carry a woman. And so, in order that people will not recognize them that they carry women into their house when they go out or in the night, what do? They open a space in their foam. When they sleep, they will be playing with the foam. Or when they enter bedroom, they will go and commit what? Masturbation. And then you become a serial masturbator. But nobody sees you with a woman. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Everybody in the yard sees you as a clean man. But you are a serial what? Masturbator. You come out, you are dying inside of yourself. People see you around in church, you look clean and decent. But inside, you are being enslaved. Or is it today, in our modern world, where they have sex machines, you go to the market, you go and buy a vibrator. And you put it at the bottom of your box for sexual gratification. But when people see you, you are a clean man or woman. You are a neat man. But instead, you are dying in the house because you are a slave to a particular thing. The Lord is calling us to repentance today. We must return to Him. Return so that their house will be clean, total, from head, so that when the devil comes, he will not see a window of entrance and he will not torment you. But otherwise, your condition becomes what? What? I pray that the Lord will deliver us this day in the name of Jesus. Because he does not want us to perish. Every heart here, every soul here, that is under the torment of the devil and his operations. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. A particular habit that is eating you up. You don't even know who to talk to. Some of us, we have grown in a particular thing in such a way that you don't even to go to Father and talk to and confide in is difficult for you. Because there is a deep-seated arrogance in you that the devil has put you in chains. May the Lord grant you liberation this day in the name of Jesus. Let us rise. I just want you to say, Jesus. Jesus. He's at the altar. You know where you stand with him. How clean is your house?
Your house is your heart. Your house is your heart. How clean is it? He has delivered you. He has delivered us from the kingdom of darkness. Sorry, media, can you put up Ephesians chapter 2 for me? Ephesians chapter 2 from verse 1. He has delivered you. Call his name Jesus. This is what the Lord, word of God says. He says, you we are dead in your transgressions and sins. We are dead, but he delivered us. Jesus delivered you, in which you were used to live when you followed the ways of the world and of the rulers of the kingdom of the air. Spiritism, the spirit who is now at work in those who are disobedient. Hey, but Jesus delivered us. All of us used also lived among them, and one time gratifying the cravings of our flesh and following its desires and thoughts. Like the rest, we were by nature deserving of wrath. The wrath of God was upon us. But today Jesus has delivered you. Can child of God, can you lift up your hand and say, Lord, I bless you. But because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, delivered us, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. It is by grace you've been saved. Can you lift up your hand and bless the name of Jesus? Call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. Every spirit that is in your life at this hour, call his name Jesus. Child of God, be on your feet and call the name of Jesus. By that action, you are rejecting any power that is operational in your life tonight. I don't know where that power is coming from, but once more, call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. I don't know that habit that the devil had returned with to make your condition worse. You rejected sin, but eventually you find yourself back in it, in a worse condition. Can you call his name Jesus? Child of God, call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. Every incubus and succubus spirit that is inhabiting in you, I want you to hear and call his name Jesus. Every Ashmodu spirit that is oppression in your life, as you call his name Jesus. Pack your load and go. Pack your load and go. Every negative power in my life, pack your load and go. Tell it to that power. Pack your load and go. Pack your load and live my life. Tell that spirit out of my life. I reject you. I reject you. I reject you. You negative power. You Kratos power. You power of lust. You power of gluttony. Call his name Jesus. Confess Jesus, child of God. That power that wants to destroy you, adulterous spirits, every power of impurity in my life, call his name Jesus. Oh,
upstairs. Any power that has been enslaving you. Exalt the name of Jesus in your life. Exalt Jesus in your life. And every other power and every other authority will go. Begin to welcome the Lord Jesus. Tell him, Lord, I accept you. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I reject every promptings of the devil and his agents that are operational in my life. Confess Jesus. For those who are in Christ Jesus, they are new creatures. Every negative authority, your hand. Everybody in this church, lift up your hands and you say to the Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I reject every negative spirit in my life. I reject every spirit of lesbianism. I reject every spirit of manipulation. I reject every spirit of homosexuality that is ravaging my life, that has made me useless, that has spoiled my spiritual holiness. In the name of Jesus, I reject every spirit of masturbation in my life. And I ask, welcome you, Lord Jesus, into my life. Every door, every window of fornication and adultery that I have opened in my life, as I accept you today, Lord Jesus, I ask that you give me the grace to close these windows, that your spirit will guide and lead me. Every door of sorcery in my life, of consulting oracles, of consulting witch doctors, of consulting diviners in my life, I reject you. 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 In the name of Jesus. Child of God, lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. I want us to go to the foot of the cross of Jesus, where the blood is flowing from his head, from his legs, from his hands, from his wounded side, and begin to plead the blood of Jesus, that every malevolent force, every vicious force of evil that has been manipulating your life this day, that you do not understand what is happening to you, that they be destroyed.
Into my life.
Into begin to plead the blood of Jesus.
Come
blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus. At the foot of the cross, he made it all. Every returned spirit, every spirit that has returned to enslave you to a worse condition, at the foot of the cross, let the weight of the blood of Jesus sanctify, purify, deliver you, free you, in the name of Jesus. Child of God, lift up your hand.
The blood of Jesus set me free from sin and sorrow. Blood of Jesus set me free.
See that blood.
The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus set me free from sin and sorrow. The blood of Jesus set me free.
Begin to bleed the blood. 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 The precious blood. 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 Lift up your hands. Close your eyes. Sorry, media, can you bring up that picture of Jesus on the
screen again. Look at him. Look at him on the cross. Look at him on the cross. Look at him. 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 Look at that blood. Just look at it. Look at it. Look at it. Blood. Blood. From his head. From his hands. From his legs. From his wounded side. Hey. Flow. 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 Let that blood redeem and deliver. Let it redeem and deliver every force of the enemy that is aimed at destroying you. I crucify it to that blood.
Lord,
break that yoke. Break that yoke. See the blood. I want somebody to drink that blood 7 times. Open your mouth. Take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let there be deliverance for you in the name of Jesus. That condition of death, that pronouncement of death, I cancel it with the power in the blood of Jesus. 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 Take that blood. Take it. 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 That power of death, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. That grave that has been dug, I cover you. I cover that grave. I cover that grave. I cover that grave. I cover that grave. I cover that grave.
In the name of Jesus.
Child of God, lift up your hands. See the blood. See the blood. The word of God says, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. See the blood. See the blood. The blood is flowing anew. It's flowing anew. It's flowing anew. It's flowing anew. It's flowing anew. Father, Father, let that blood flow anew. I touch the tongues on his head again. I touch the tongues with the mantle of the priesthood. I touch the tongues on his head again. I touch the tongues on his head again. I provoke the anointing of the blood on his head again with the tongues upon him. That head injury and sickness will go from you in the name of Jesus. Go to the foot of the cross. Go to the foot of the cross. In Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus, please, those who are pregnant in this church and also those seeking for the fruit of the womb, I want you up here, please. Pregnant and those seeking for the fruit of the womb. By your instruction and direction, I ask that you will bless many here with the fruit of the womb.
Amen.
By this time, July next year, may many stand to present their new babies unto you in the name of Jesus. Every stronghold of the enemy that has stopped some from conceiving, even when you have released the baby, may that stronghold be broken in the name of Jesus. May your angel visit them this day, so that in the next 9 months they will come back to this church to testify in the name of Jesus. Those you have already blessed with the fruit of the womb, Lord, I ask that no form of complication will deny them their joy in the name of Jesus. That you, Father, will protect them, and that when their time is due, they will deliver their babies in the name of Jesus. And may the blood of Jesus be upon you. May the blood of Jesus protect you. May the blood of Jesus deliver you. And may the blood of Jesus grant you safe delivery and fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. Can go back. In the name of Jesus, this is for the men. For the men, you want God to bless you. But please listen to this. You have to come up here. But make sure your hands and your legs are in one place. If you have put your legs in two places, church and somewhere else, don't come out here. For the men who want God's blessing, special blessing, you may ask the Lord for a blessing, come up here. But if you know you have put your hand somewhere else, don't come. Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, in our text today, you gave the story of deliverance, and the devil goes about roaming without finding a place and returns. Here are your sons who seek your blessing, who seek your intervention in their lives, the work of their hands, their businesses, their jobs. And Lord, you have promised to bless them, those who search for you. With this disposition of openness and sincere desire to be blessed by you, may your blessing be upon them. May your protection be upon them. Anyone here that has been marked out or projected for destruction, projected for death, Father, under this corporate unction of this day of appointment with you, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. May the designs you have planned for them be made manifest in their lives in the name of Jesus. Those that their destinies have been tied by the demonic powers and authority,
under the corporate unction of the priesthood, Father, I lose it. I lose them. 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 In the name of Jesus. Father, any of them that is under any spell emanating from the wickedness, emanating from principalities and powers, even those that there is a raw power that has been working against them, Father, may they experience deliverance this day in the name of Jesus. And may your favor rest upon them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Jesus, oh, don't forget me. Jesus, oh, don't forget me.
up your hands. Tell the Lord Jesus, thank you. Thank him for today. Lord, we thank you and we bless your name. May your spirit guide us, and may our deliverance be made permanent in the name of Jesus. May no return evil attack us in the name of Jesus. Every window that has been closed, may it be permanently closed in the name of Jesus. Every door of evil that has been closed, may it be permanently closed in the name of Jesus. And may the grace of God abide with us both now and forevermore. Amen. Just before the Thanksgiving, please, just a reminder of the appeal for church cleaning tomorrow that I made to the youth. But those of us also who can be a part of it to help us clean the church environment, please. Come with your shovel and rake, those who can, and those who have wheelbarrow that can come along, please. We will appreciate and God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Ihe ahụ I mere Chineke na ime kakwa Ọ bụ ya bụ ihe m ji wee bịa n'ihu gị taa o Ebe ahụ I lotere m mgbe olila ya agwụla